गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू समग्र शिक्षा आंध्र प्रदेश ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। माय नेम इज आर कृष्णवेणी, वर्किंग एज अ सोशल सीआरटी इन केजीबीवी बोंडपल्ली विजयनगरम डिस्ट्रिक्ट। हाउ आर यू चिल्ड्रन? ऑल आर यू हैप्पी एंड सेफ? ओके चिल्ड्रन, इन नाइन्थ क्लास द लेसन 12th, जस्ट what you understood in our 8th class. It is very strange lesson to you. Why? Because it is totally related to European history. So, what is European history? In that time, you see the world map. The Europe has not been situated in the present states and countries. Is not there in those times. So, in this lesson, you read about and discuss about the how the cultural changes, humanist ideas, humanial behaviors, how they change it. It is clearly you discuss in this class. Okay. So, the lesson is changing cultural traditions in Europe. So, he is clearly noted. Changing. There is a change in what's the change? Cultural and also traditional. In those times, 1300 to 1800. So, clearly, we have a doubt raised. Changes between that 1300 to 1800, why? What is the before of the 1300? What is after of the 1800? So, he has a raised a doubt. So, what is the changes? Earlier at that point, we know about what is that position of that before 1300. So, what is that situation is happened in the before 1300, in especially in Europe. So, we have to discuss about that times. That timelines is that ancient period. How the years are divided into the historians, it is indicated to ancient period up to 400 AD. What is means of AD? Another domain. AD means 0 to 400 AD. The time is called ancient period. The time is called ancient period. And next, 400 AD to 1300 AD, we call that period medieval period. We call that period is medieval period. So next, 1300 AD to 1800 AD, we call that period is early modern period. Early modern period. Next, modern period, 1800 to at present. Okay, children, you clearly observe that ancient period. Ancient period up to 400 AD. Up to 400 AD. So, in the ancient time, it is a very well known and rich empires in that Europe. So, what is the empires? How the European states and European cities, how they eat? And the cultural changes? And what not everything? How it is that in the ancient time? And what's going on that medieval period? In the period, we discuss about that in the period. And also early modern period, 1300 to 1800 AD. So, this time, 1300 to 1800 AD, this time only our lesson. Okay? And then, modern period, you are see about that 1800 to present. It is called modern period. In the ancient time, in the ancient medieval world, in ancient time, the total world, especially in Europe, is dominated by that Roman Empire. Dominated by the Roman Empire. The topic is ancient medieval world in Europe. So, here is the 2 points, ancient and also medieval world in Europe. First of all, we discuss about the ancient Europe. In the ancient Europe, in the time of that, up to 400 AD, The Europe was dominated by the Roman Empire. So, this is the Roman Empire is dominated by the not only Europe and all also Turkey, Egypt. All the areas are that controlled over by the Roman Empire. So these Roman Empire have a great cities like Rome and Alexandria. In the Roman Empire, great cities, Rome and Alexandria. These cities are that well-known, flourished and well-known, developed also. At the same time, here is that in the time of that Roman Empire, the culturally developed in those aspects of that cultural, sculpture and paintings and buildings also. So, in those times, so Roman Empire is a very great empire. It is well-developed empire in Europe and all aspects. Not only one thing, great cities are there and trade is expand to other countries and also and the sculpture and paintings, literature, philosophy, buildings, what not, every aspect, it is totally largely a very high order. So this is the Roman Empire greatness in the Europe. Okay, Roman Empire declined in the era 400 AD. So in the time of that Roman Empire, all the cultural and sculpture, paintings, these are all aspect as developed. In the time of the 400 AD, the Roman Empire was declined. The total situation will be changed. What is the changes? All the people are lived in, nowadays people live in that villages and also great cities are declined. At the same time, so many people are will be turned into that peasants. Trade is minimal. All the changes are that happened after the Roman Empire declined. Once again, total people are living not in cities. They have to turn it into villages. Trade is minimal. And that there is no any development aspect in those times. So there is no any large emperors and there is no great empire in those times. There is no way at all. Europe came to be dominated by that social system of that feudalism. Social system of feudalism. What is the feudalism? Feudalism is that political power of that warrior landlords and the landlords. They have to came to be controlled to that villages and also peasants. So they have to wanted to conquer that in those times of Europe. Feudalism, the warrior landlords are controlled on the peasants and other lands and also villages. This is feudalism, that warrior lands and warlords control the peasants. These peasants are all in Europe are serfs. These peasants are all in Europe as serfs. What is the means of serf? Serf means an agriculture labors. Serf means an agriculture labors. And labor bounded by the feudals. Feudal system. Bounded by the feudal system. So this is that time of the serfs. They have to own land. But they did not cultivate their land. They are totally bound the feudals and also they have to work their fields and also fight for against fight for them and also they did not cultivate their lands and their lands cultivated with the support of their families. So this is the step. All the people in Europe under the controlled by the feudalism, the peasants are all serfs. Peasants are all serfs. Who was that? What was that? They are working. They are working their fields also. And that they fight for against that feudals and also. In those times that you have to clearly point out that the cultural aspects of that Europe. We see before the before decline of the Roman Empire, the culturally it is a large, very large high order. After the decline of the Roman Empire, culturally, totally, the power with only dominated by the Roman Catholic Church. What not everything, Roman Catholic Church controlled the cultural aspects and people's lives, their thoughts also. So, it is a greater change. A Roman Catholic Church, it is followed by the rules by the Christianity faith. Christianity faith, they did not allow the people's own thinking. What they tell the priest, by the priest, they follow the and they follow the priest ideas. In those times that Roman Catholic Church impact of the people, they did not want to allow the own thinking of the people, and they disgrace their ideas. They disgrace their ideas. And this situation changed after that 1300 AD. So the 1300 AD, that is the time of the early modern period. Early modern period. In the time of the modern period came, the total situation of the people, peasants, are totally changed. What not? Socially and also culturally. Socially, culturally, the time is totally changed after that 1300 AD. So that great revolt in the England in 1381, the peasants, they did not wanted to controlled by the feudals. They eagerly resist the warrior lords, landlords and that feudals. What is the resist? They did not want to bound their ideas. They resist their power and also great revolt of England. Great revolt of in a most important. Children, you underline the point in your textbook and follow it. And England in 1381, great revolt. This revolt is changes that suffrage system. It is ended of the suffrage system. They have did not want to be serfs as a serf to the feudals. So the in the revolt, they won the revolt and also the ended of that. The end of that feudalism and serfdom system. End of the serfdom system. These are the revolt. Similar revolts are happened in the other countries also. These are the same revolts. They have been inspired by the England serfs. These are revolts are that happened. Similar revolts are happened to surrounding countries to Europe. At the same time, they have to they have to encourage their own thinking and also be. They have to trade to other countries. Not only other countries, trade between the European countries and also distant places. Like that, distant places, countries in China, Arabia and India and Egypt also. They have to time and that the cities also flourished. In the time of the Roman Empire cities, what they have to develop cities, and again these cities are the developed. At the same time, the trade is expanded to other countries like China, Arabia, Egypt and India also. At the same time, they have to large time is to spend their views and their ideas. They have to enjoy and the freedom. They have to enjoy and the freedom. Most villages turned into cities. And the time of the using of the trade, and these cities are turned into municipalities and also. At the same time, they have to own thinking. They have their own thinking. But they did not depend on what the Catholic Church, Roman Catholic Church priests are said that they did not to allow the priest's ideas. And also the cities and municipalities are come together at the time of that 1300 AD. So children, here is that clearly we understood what the before of the Roman Empire and the decline of the Roman Empire. This situation we are clearly understood. Before the Roman Empire, the Europe is well developed, and decline the Roman Empire, total situation is changes to bad. Okay, this situation will be changed in the 1300 to 1800. This is the humanist ideas are that they followed, and they reback that what the ideas we lose by the decline of the Roman Empire, they gain it. And also all that in the Roman Catholic Church influence, they all forgotten their ideas, their knowledge and their spiritual religious ideas, all these are forgotten. The time is changes to the in the time of 1300 AD. Next, the culture, new cultural domination, it started in the Europe. What is that? The cultural movement. What is that? The people began to search what the ideas they have to own thinking. And the question to the religious priest, what the Roman Catholic Church influenced by the people, they have to question them. They did not want to go beyond that priest ideas. And they have begun to search the new ways to approach. New ways to approach and that great adventures also. At the same time, they have to develop the all aspects of that. What the adventures? They began to search that distance places and the same trade routes. And also, what they lost are that the Roman Empire culture totally began to revive it. And also develop in cultural and spiritual and that same time sculpture and buildings, paintings, all these are developed in those cultural movements again. This cultural movement began the word used in the Renaissance. Renaissance, we later on that discuss that topic Renaissance. And then they began to wanted to know about the far places. Voyagers and search the far places and also trade to the distance places. And then they have to search a better way. They have to search a better way to reach the God. Did not any middleman interference. But who is the middleman? Priest. Who's that influence the Roman Catholic Church? So, in those time, humanist ideas are developed and they began to search the way to connect the God in the simply ways. They did not want to any interference of the middleman. And they did not follow any words and they did not go to beyond that religious priest ideas. In those time, they declined that all the development will be rebirth. That is called Renaissance. And the Renaissance. Renaissance and also they are known as that rebirth. This the term is used in the time of that historians. In the 14th century, historians used the term Renaissance. Renaissance means rebirth. What is rebirth? And what will be rebirth? What the Roman Empire declined the development. Roman Empire, what the development has the Roman Empire? These development, all aspects of development, all are rebirth. So, they have the clear idea of that. This is the cultural and political, at the same time social. These the development will be rebirth. So, in the 14th century, historians use the word rebirth or renaissance. Why 14th century? It is happened in 1300. The 1301 we reach that 14th century. We reach that 1399. This is the time we call that 14th century. In the 14th century, what's the documents and also paintings, sculptures, galleries, literature, what not everything in the all these preserved in the galleries. All these items are preserved. In those, these items are belong to the time of that Roman Empire. The all the items are preserved in the galleries and archives for in the Europe and also America. This is very clearly understood. What is the development? What is the greatness of that Roman Empire? We have to clearly understood. So, in the 14th century, still now we have to go to Europe and America. We see all the document monuments and the documents, paintings, sculptures, and also buildings. Everything we have to see in that European galleries and American archives. Okay, next, in the 19th century, Renaissance, the word is used by the historians. Historians means that this word, why the use of this word Renaissance? It is mostly wanted that we have to recall and we have to regain the development in the all aspects and the cultural change of this period. So Renaissance means it is change. What is going on that Roman Empire? What is the medieval empire? And what is the early modern period? It is totally they wanted to gain the cultural change. So, as a Swiss scholar, he belongs to Switzerland. Whose the people are belongs to Switzerland? It is called Swiss. We belong to India. So, we are called as Indians. So, in the Switzerland people, we have to call Swiss. Swiss scholar Jacob Burckhardt. His time is 1818 to 1907. Swiss scholar, very most important. You underline it, you note down in your notebooks, and also otherwise you screenshot it. And yes, Swiss scholar Jacob Burckhardt. His time is 1818 to 97. He belongs to which country? Switzerland. He belongs to Switzerland country. what he understood. He wrote about that. He is clearly idea of the cultural aspects of the Europe. And then he wrote a book, The Civilization of the Renaissance. The Civilization of the Renaissance in Italy. The Civilization of the Renaissance in Italy. You have to clearly understood. 1818. So 1800 to completed the 1300 to 1800 is that early modern period. So 1800 after we have to go to the modern period at present. So here Swiss scholar Jacob Burckhardt, he wrote a book, The Civilization of the Renaissance in Italy. Civilization of Renaissance in Italy. In this book, he explained and he wrote so many things of that time of the cultural aspects and buildings, sculptures. You have an idea of the children in this lesson. What is the cultural change in the time of the Roman Empire and the present? We have to lose that all the cultural and traditions in Europe. We have to gain it. So this is the idea of that cultural changing in the cultural traditions in Europe in this lesson. The civilization of the Renaissance. Civilization. It is known about it. It is a modern. Civilization means come to an ancient to modern. Civilization of the Renaissance in Italy. Civilization of the Renaissance in Italy. In this book, he explained it. He criticized it and explained it what he ideas and his views in those times of the Roman Empire and nowadays. He also discussed about that medieval man was only dependent upon the Roman Catholic Church ideas. He is one of the bound and one of the slave of that Catholic Church. And the medieval man, they did not have any idea of their own thinking. So, he is completely bound of that priest words. So, what not everything. The priest did not want to tell that truth of the Bible. They have to only gain the amount and the same of the power. The medieval man. In the modern man, he is very clearly given a separation of that medieval man and the modern man. Jacob explained it in his book. The modern man is that did not want to go to the middleman effect. Okay, modern man, he has a great thinking, own thinking. He did not want to group. He have a developed in individual aspect. He did not want to a one of the group member. Modern man is wanted to one of the individual aspects, individual identity. So he have a great idea. He have an own thinking. He know about that what's going on the world and what's going on the Europe. And the modern man also reached the God in the simple way, did not interference of the middleman. What steps to be taken to reach the God? Did not want to follow the priest words. Okay. So the next topic is the revival of Italian cities. The revival of Italian cities. What is the Italian cities are important? Cities importance. At the same time, in the time of the expansion of the trade routes. Trade routes between that Byzantine Empire and also Islamic countries. The expansion of the trade routes. Trading between the two countries of Byzantine and also Islamic countries. In the time of that Italy, they have to port cities are revived. All the port cities are revived. Where is Italy is located? Italy is the middle part of the Mediterranean Sea. It is very close to the sea routes to whatever countries are that to trade to Italy. It is very so many port areas to have in Italy country. So ports are revived in the Italy coast. Once again, Italy is situated in the Mediterranean Sea. Okay, so in the port cities are revived in the Italian coast, all countries are interested to begin to trade with the Italy, European countries. It is the easy way to trade that and reach that country. And 12th century and also in the time of the Mongols also opened with their trade routes with China and also Western European countries. It is the landmark of that land route and also reached that sea route also. Land route we have to go to the China and also reach that European, Western European countries through the North America and also Atlantic Ocean. 12th century Mongols opened with China trade route to Western European countries. Children, you have to understand that map is a very flat shape and square, and also you have to imagine yourself in it is the spherical shape. It is a spherical shape. So Mongols opened to with China and land route they tried to the Western European countries. And then this the time of the trade, Italian towns and cities have played an important role, a crucial role in that time of the trade. And then all the cities are in a European country, and especially Italian cities, they did not want to a part of that powerful empire. They did not want to part of a powerful empire. They need to that individual or independent cities. They began to know, wanted to individual cities that they did not want to play a part of their powerful empires. And some of the cities, states are in the Italy, Florence and Venice. Florence and Venice are the, in the times of that, they have the very vibrant cities. Why vibrant? They especially they have a great quality in those cities, those states, Florence and Venice. These states are republic. These states are republic. And also Venice and Genoa. Venice and Genoa. These also vibrant cities. Why especially these cities are vibrant? They have an important aspect is in the European country, in Italy especially, two states are that republic, very most important. Two states are republic. What is the states? Florence and Venice. And two states are that vibrant cities. What is that? Venice and Genoa. Venice and Genoa, they did not want to go about that. They did not know any powerful immense of that clergy. They did not any influence clergy people. Who is the clergy? Clergy means member of the church. The priest, bishops and cardinals and also pope. Here is then some of the categories in the church post and church officials. The higher officials of the church is called pope. At the same time, we have to know about pastor, priest and bishops, archbishop, cardinals and also higher official is called pope. In the time of that clergymen, they did not want to do any influence in that. They did not want to accept of the clergymen's influence in Venice and Genoa. And the time of that, the artisans and also merchants and businessmen say play a key role. They have to go to the want the citizenship. Citizenship of the important and independent cities. And that in the feudal system, in the empire of the European countries, what is the feudal landlords is go behind there, and they did not want to go there, their slaves. They did not want to weaken the idea of that citizenship. So, the Venice is Genoa is a vibrant cities. These cities are not influenced by the clergy people. These clergy people also the impact of the Roman Catholic Church. So, here is that they did not want to any influence. Why? Because they are already independent. They are already developed. And all the trade routes and trade is well known expansion of the other countries also. They really, they wanted to know what they happen in other countries and still their states also. So, it is just a comparison of that. What's going on our states and what's going on other countries. So, all these are that you have to compare it. Next topic is humanism and universities. Humanism. In the time of that medieval time, in the early modern period, and all the aspects are reflected in and interested of the life. The people have to begin to study what interested of that life. What all the aspects are reflected by the man. And begins to study the interest of the life. And also, they wanted to know about the more things and more information about the world, where they lived, not only life, and they also wanted to know about the more things about the world. And students of that ancient Greeks literatures, students, they have to belongs to in the ancient Greeks, they wanted to deals what's the literature deals with that at the same time with the nature. They these that nature and also sciences and also world and the realistic things. The students began to know about the information of the world and also what is the world is beside and surroundings that nature and these and interested of the man. The students of the ancient Greeks, they began to study that world and also nature. These the students is we have to call that humanist. These the humanist began to search their life and also the world which is dependent upon our they have to interact with each other to world and also life. And that what is that began to interact? Humanists have studied to nature and science and arts. Nature. This nature is very impact of that how that time of the Roman Empire well established. These the nature also supported the how that medieval period of that priest and church officials are that impacted. And science and arts, all these times of that three periods, Roman Empire, medieval and early modern period. These the humanists began to study about the new more information about that time. In the time of the in 1453, Constantinople, this is the Constantinople present the capital city of the Istanbul and Turkey. This is the Constantinople was overthrown. Overthrown by the which country? Turkey. Turkey means Ottoman Empire. This is the Ottoman Empire of the Turkey, the overthrown of the Constantinople. This is the Constantinople totally occupied by that Eastern Roman Empire. So, Eastern Roman Empire occupied by the Turkey or Ottoman Empire in the time of that 1453. At the same time, Turkish or Ottoman Empire took the place of that Eastern Roman Empire. Eastern Roman Empire. In the time of that, many of the intellectuals began to go to the far off the places. They also hold their Greek books and their valuable books and valuable material also. And that in the time of that, they began to go to the Italy. They have to have a security. They spoke only the Greek words. And many of them educated them Greeks and Greek books and also that increased the interest of the Italians also increased the interest of that Greek books and also Greek literature. They have to have a phobia. By the time of the Eastern Roman Empire, they declined all the literature of the Greeks. So, all the intellectual persons and the humanists, they began to go to that, take that all the valuable books to reach the Italy. In Italy, the students of that humanist and all are that to preserve that the greatness of the Greek literature. And the Italian students also began to know about, speak about that Greek words. They interested to know about the Greek literature and Greek languages. In the time of that Italy, it is very fashion to that, some of the feel fashion to know about that Greek language. And the many known about that fashion in Italy to know about the Greek words and Greek literature. It is well known that they have a status. They feel they have a status to know about the Greek words. In the time of that, humanist and university. At the same time, they have so many universities that came to that in the Italy. In the universities, they teach that subjects, new subjects like that Greek words and Greek languages. So, all the students do know about the world and nature and their life. They did not want to that what's going on the past. They have know about that future life, future world. Because the Greek language is more flourishing that our future life, it is said they wanted to study. Okay, humanists started in Italy, and these the humanists spread neighboring countries like Italy and soon spread to France, England, and the Netherlands also. These the humanists started in Italy. Now, this humanism is spread over through that France, England, and also Netherlands. And universities also established to do the new subject law and religion. At the same time, the Dutch man, the Dutchman Erasmus. Very famous, famous Dutchman Erasmus. And these the Erasmus Dutchman. Which people are called Dutchman? Netherlands people are called Dutchmans, Dutchies. The Dutchman Erasmus, the time of the 1466 to 1536, initially the New Testament in the original Greek language. He only studied that, what is the old or the New Testament of the original piece? He studied that in the language of the Greek. He know very well about the word that Jesus Christ is told to us. So the original New Testament is that original series of the Bible. So he is Erasmus clearly understood that what the Jesus Christ told. And then he criticized the priest ideas. They are eagerly diverted into their ideas and converted the Bible into priest ideas. They did not told about the what is actually Jesus Christ said. They know they to teach ourselves to the Catholic Church and the priest ideas. The Price of Folly, the great book is written by that Erasmus. The Price of Folly, the book is written by the Erasmus. In this book, he criticized. He realized that great ideas of the Jesus Christ, which is told about in the Bible, and that acquired the books from that Arab. They have to gain the more books Arabs and retranslated in the Greek and then to Latin. In those times of that, these are retranslation of that Bible also retranslation to the so many and reprinted to so many languages. It is easy to understand to every country people, not only some of the Greeks and also all over the world to Greece also that Bible is Price of Folly is in Greek and also retranslated into Latin language. Okay, here only see that world map. In this map, the Europe is shaded in red color. So you observe it, the Europe is connected with that Asia and also some parts of that northern hemisphere. And the another picture, you see that Europe, especially Europe map. In this picture, you see the Italy. Italy is located in the Mediterranean Sea and also very close to that African continent. And Portugal, Spain, some of that countries are that very, very useful to sea routes. And here only see the picture, Italian states. Some of the Italian states of the Padua, Venice and Mantua, Florence, Genova, all these are that Italian states. These the Italian states are that culturally developed and also trade, according to trade, is flourished. So here only we see the picture, Italian states, Rome. Rome is the capital city of Italy. This is the Rome is the center point of that Roman Empire and also Byzantine Empire. And the occupation of that people, they have to, first of all, they have to given a more importance to cultural activities. So here only artist and realism. The humanist ideas extended to art and architecture too. The humanist ideas, we already discussed about that. Humanist ideas are began to study nature and world and also how the man is thinking about that world itself. And then here is all that arts and like painting, sculpture, this took the form of the realism. Artists observe the nature and observe the nature, the people and the place around them and sought to represent them as they were. We have to see in so many paintings, sculptures. But in the Rome, Italy,
they haven't seen the pictures and paintings which is realistic. They see what they see and they represent in the sculptures and paintings and also buildings. In the sphere of the visual arts like painting, sculpture, this took to the form of the realism. And what the artists have observed the nature, and this is very very different from the spirit of the religious art promoted by the church in the feudal times. Feudal times church is prominented by that religious ideas only. But in the time of that early modern period, artists are gave the importance to nature and realistic world. What they observe their surroundings, what the people have their situations gone in their life, all these are painted with realistic manner. So the religious art emphasized religious themes and depicting people and things according to social some ideas forms. So here is that art was supposed by the supposed to represent those ideals and not the reality around them once upon a time. But in the time of that, now artist also Renaissance began to priority Renaissance given to priority what they have to feel, what they have experience. These the things are that follow the paintings and also sculptures. And then here artists also began to study remains of that Roman culture, their buildings and sculpture too. In the time of that artist power and they feel feelings, power and strength of the human beings. One implication of this trend was to study the real world of the nature and the human beings also. So it is given importance to the real world, what they which type of the world they feel, real world, and began to study to interesting thing, what life is they have to carry on and which type of the world they have to experience. So these the things is humanist interest to study. And then next, artist also behavior that in the 1416, the 1416 Donatello broke new ground with his lifelike statues. First of all, this administration of their figures, they have to draw and make that perfectly proportionized men and women, and also sculptured so many centuries ago. And that Italians made the sculptures want to continue the old tradition. What is the old tradition? Roman Empire tradition. They wanted to continue the Roman Empire tradition. In the time of 1416, the famous person Donatello, in the time of the 1386 to 1466, he broke out new ground with his life-like statues. What is a life-like statues? This statue seemed to be very realistic. It is that they have the, there is no picture or the sculpture. This is the real item. So humans are behave that act the sculpture. We have to small confusion to see the pictures and sculptures. And Andreas Vesalius, a Belgian and a professional of medicine at the University of Padua, was the first to dissect the human body and the same time to study the person's bone structure. Bone structure is also very useful to make sculptures. Why? Because the bone structure is dependent upon that height of the sculpture and also paintings. At the same time, they have to give an importance to how the body formation, how the body structure is dependent upon the bone structure. But sculptures, how do you know bone structure, how the bone structure is in the body? So, and the artists went to laboratories after medical schools they have to go to medical school and observe the body and dissect the body to know how the body parts of that person and the women or men, and they are clearly known about that body parts and what is the nerves and nervous system, bone system. All these things are that very useful to make the sculptures. This is only done by the Andreas Vesalius, a Belgian and a professor of medicine at the University of Padua. Andreas Vesalius is known as he is the Andreas Vesalius, in the time of the 1514 and 64, a Belgian and a professor of the medicine at the University of Padua, was the first to dissection of the human body. Dissection means cut the human body and to study the how the body parts are that contain it, and that nervous system and also bone system. This was the beginning of the modern physiology. This is the main thing is done by the Andreas Vesalius. This is the first step to the art, develop the modern physiology. At the same time, here is the human body. At the same time, here is observed that the person Andreas Vesalius, Donatello. Donatello is that make your sculptures and statues at the perfect proportionized his style. So in this picture you will clearly see that person Donatello, and that next art is embedded to in nature. He who can extract it has it the more closely your work abides by life in its form, so much the better will it appear. No man shall ever be able to make a beautiful figure out of his own imagination unless he has well stored his mind by much copying from life. This words is said to that Albrecht Dürer. So here is the picture is given in the slide. This is the praying hands. What is the praying hand? This is a sketch by the Dürer. This picture is sketched by the Dürer. What he said that according to this picture, praying hands. These the praying hands gives us a sense of Italian culture. And in the 16th century, this words is that Dürer. This picture is tells us the Italian culture in the 16th century, when the people were deeply religious but also had a sense of confidence in man's ability to achieve near perfection and to unravel the mysteries of the world and the universe. Every man should have a knowledge, but there is no make a beautiful figure out of in his mind, in his own imagination, unless he has well stored his mind by the much copying from life. Everybody should experience what he make any sculpture. First of all, he experienced it. He know about it. He imagined it. That's why they began to make a new type of sculptures, and perfectly and realistic sculptures they will be made it. So these the views of that Dürer. Make the sculpture is draw the sketch of that Dürer. It is the praying hands. See the children, the hands is were very clearly know about the veins, nervous system, at the same time stretches and the hands and cloth. So and what the prefer to that given a light and dark. The picture is clearly show that what they have to want and what they have to feel. It is that very clear to give an information to us. Next, here is that Dürer sketch. At the same time, here is that very, very important. Many artists like Leonardo da Vinci. Many artists like who is the great person? Leonardo da Vinci studied human anatomy so as to make their painting and sculpture realistic. So he is also one of the sculptor, and he make their paintings and sculpture realistic. Why? Because that have to study that anatomy. Why? Because these anatomy related to human body parts, human body structure, human body sciences. So they are well known to know about that human body structure, and they make the sculptures and paintings in a realistic manner. So painters found that knowledge of the geometry, at the same time, geometry helped them understand the perspective, and that by noting the changes, changing the quality of the light, their picture acquiring the three-dimensional quality. What is a three-dimensional quality? The picture, the sculpture or picture is very close to realistic. So the painters found that they have to begin acquire the knowledge of the geometry and also trigonometry, and also they have to physics, how the light is reflected, and anatomy at the same time, physiology. So all these sciences are developed in those times of the early modern period. So all the sciences are very useful to sculptures to use that paintings and sculptures and also sketching. They have to begin to do the work with three-dimensional qualities also, and the perspective way of the depicting different things on paintings. On paintings, so that we can feel the depth of that in the painting. This is done by showing the objects in the larger, showing the larger and objects behind it as smaller. You see that a very very well known this picture of the Pita. This is that the statue, the Pita. That is means Pita means very sympathy manner pictures and sympathy manner sculptures. We see the picture or sculpture, we feel that heartly, what a sorrowful feelings. And this is the statue, the Pita, by the Michelangelo, depicts Mary holding the body of the Jesus. In this picture, you see clearly one lady carries the man. Who's the lady? The Mary. Mary, he is the mother of that Jesus Christ. So he carry his son. At the time of that, he have so much of the wounds there in her body. At the same time, here is that anatomy and geometry, physics, as well as strong sense of what was the beautiful, gave a new quality to Italian art. So all these items are very interesting. The use of the oil paintings in those times, they always use the oil paintings, a medium of painting, and also gave that greater richness of color to painting than before. And they use the oil paintings. They never before that using the oil paints in the time of that modern period. They use oil paints also in the colors and designs of the costumes in many paintings. In many paintings, there is evidence of the influence of the Chinese and Persians art. If the paintings of that influence, these the paintings of that Italy, all these paintings are influenced the Chinese art and also Persian art. At the time of that, Leonardo da Vinci had a amazing range of the interest from the botany and anatomy. So here is that we call that which was called to be realism and which continued till the 19th century. So these realism is very, very, very useful to that. What is the humanist or the recall or rebirth? Because of that Roman Empire, what they lost and they acquired the realistic ideas and acquire the cultural and traditional in Europe, they reback and rebirth and renaissance that what not everything they have to done only by the cultural changes. So Leonardo da Vinci is that time of that 1452. 1452 was an amazing range of interest from the botany and anatomy. He painted the Mona Lisa and the Last Supper. Children, here only the Last Supper. The Last Supper means Jesus Christ giving the supper to all their faiths. And next, Mona Lisa picture. Mona Lisa picture also amazing range of interest of the Leonardo da Vinci's paintings. So he painted the Mona Lisa on the you see that right side, and the last supper is also left side. So these are one of the his dreams was to be able to fly. We can easily understood what his mind, what he thinking in his mind. And he spent years observing birds in flight and designed a flying machine. And he signed his name, Leonardo da Vinci, disciple of the experiment. So children, this is the cultural and traditional changes in that Europe. It is mainly the church to now encouraged. First of all, you see that the Roman Catholic Church discredits the ideas of the human beings. And then now that modern period, the church also to encourage the new art, and popes and other leaders of the church commissioned great the artists like Michelangelo and Raphael to paint for them and also design the buildings for them and even make elaborate graves and memorials here for them. So here is that we have to clearly observe the church also encouraged. Church also encouraged the humanist ideas. What they gain back to Renaissance, rebirth that Roman culture, Roman, the great Roman Empire, the cultural traditions, what they re back. So all these items are welcomed to that church now also. And here is the very very important pictures and the Last Supper and the Mona Lisa. Children, I hope all you understand this lesson, and I will give you a small assignment. Now note the questions. How do you think trade helps in the development of towns? So here is the towns and cities. Towns and cities are flourished in the Italy. And these cities are the how to develop development of that trade and helps to that trading, and also two things. And the second one, do you think there is a greater possibility of the knowing new ideas and trying out the new things in the towns rather than the villages discussed? There is a short difference between the villages and that urban areas. Which places are hope to better to ideas and hope to that trying to new things? Which place is it? And you have a small discussion and also write it. Okay, children, you clearly follow the video and also answer it. And in the last assignment is given here, locate the republic and three court cities on the outline of the map of Italy. I will already shown about the map of Italy. You clearly observe the map and identify that republics. What is the republics? Here is only we already discussed about that Florence and Venice are the republics. You just identify and locate it. At the same time, next question. Who were the humanists and what did they teach? These are the four questions I will give in a small assignment. Children, I hope you understand. Otherwise, you will see the video again. And you clearly follow the textbook line to line. You prepared your notes and understood very well. Okay? Thank you.